Choose solar panels made in America. We get the job done right with esprit de corps and honor. Add Tesla Powerwall and prepare for blackouts. Grab the federal 26% solar and battery tax credit. No interest or payments until 2022. Call 415-354-2969. 415-354-2969. Or visit SemperSolaris.com.
26% federal tax credit based on eligibility. Consult your tax advisor. Cannot be combined with any other offers. On approved credit. New customers only. Some restrictions apply. Expires 8/31/21. CSLP number 978152.
There are no limits to what we can do together. So let's keep rising, California.
Esquina, esquina, y ahí nos vamos. El mundo es grande, pero no tengo en mis manos. Estoy muy duro, sí, ok, vamos. Y con el tiempo nos seguimos elevando.
Get vaccinated and wear a mask when it can protect you and others. Your actions save lives. To learn more, visit COVID-19.ca.gov.
Y donde está mi gente?
Better time to switch to Spectrum Mobile. You could save hundreds of dollars on your mobile bill. Plus, there are no added taxes, hidden fees, and no contracts. Try the Spectrum Mobile Savings Calculator today, and in three easy steps, you'll see how much you could save by switching. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save. Spectrum Internet required. Savings may vary. Restrictions apply. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save for details.
Look, staying healthy isn't easy. Watching your diet, hitting the gym, avoiding stress. But a good night's rest helps boost your overall health and wellness. And it couldn't be easier. The new Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed is the only bed that effortlessly adjusts in response to both of you. The result? You wake up ready for anything. Proven quality sleep is life-changing sleep. During our lowest prices of the season, the new Queen Sleep Number 360 C2 Smart Bed is only $899. Only for a limited time. To learn more, go to sleepnumber.com.
Hi, this is Joe Cordell with the law firm Cordell & Cordell. When the prospect of divorce becomes a reality, you need a partner that you can count on. If you're a man in this situation, consider contacting Cordell & Cordell. We've helped men navigate complex legal matters for 30 years.
Contact Cordell & Cordell to schedule an appointment with one of our firm's California attorneys. Online at CordellCordell.com. That's CordellCordell.com. 1455 Frazee Road, Suite 500, San Diego, California, 92108.
Before I started Rooter Hero Plumbing, I was an angry young man. Hello, I'm John McQuaid. I was angry because my dad died when I was 17 and he left me alone. I was angry because I couldn't go to college with my friends and because I had to drop out of high school. It's not a pleasant story. But as I grew older, I also grew up. I realized that my dad didn't leave me alone. He left me with values and principles that continue to shape my life. Dad said, be on time. He didn't like it when people were late. He taught me to be polite. It was something I lost, but recaptured along the way. And he taught me to keep my promises, because broken promises lead to broken relationships. We teach and keep these values at Rooter Hero Plumbing. I think we have a pretty good company. I know we have great people. And if one of our heroes fails to live up to these values, please call me. My private number is on the back of every Rooter Hero business card. You can also reach us at rooterhero.com. Thank you.
Tickets are on sale now for our 2021 iHeartRadio Music Festival. September 17th and 18th in Las Vegas. Billie Eilish, Cheap Trick, Coldplay, Dua Lipa, Florida Georgia Line, J. Cole, Journey, Khalid, Lil Baby, Maroon 5, Nelly, Sam Hunt, Weezer, special guest performance by Phineas, and more on the T-Mobile Arena Nighttime Stage. Get tickets now through AXS.com. That's AXS.com.
Portions of the following program will be recorded.
To have police officers handle suicide calls doesn't make a lot of sense. I mean, people just got tired of cops saying, yes, can I help you? Excuse me a moment.
I want sugar instead of maple on the helmet.
Oh, man.
Bill Handel. Mornings from 6 to 10.
Any cop who wants his license plate, you just email me. I'll give it to you. You wait outside the building.
On KFI. When
you left it, left us. License plate number. I would have given it to you. You could have given him a ticket for something. I would have told you there was something in his car.
Handle, by the way, is off this morning. Wayne is in for him. So we'll start Handle on the News in just a couple of minutes. But right now, let's go ahead and see if you're a little snacky this morning, shall we?
It's time for Biz Bites.
Bites of business.
Biz Bites on Wake Up Call with Jennifer Jones Lee.
Oh, Amtrak, I don't know. I hope that you can put your money where your mouth is, because Amtrak says it is going to change the way we know travel. I'm paraphrasing here, but it has made a $7.3 billion investment in new trains and infrastructure that it says will transform the future of rail travel. It's got 83 trains, some of which will be hybrid battery powered. These will be done by Siemens Mobility. Now, the new trains, they say, will reshape travel by replacing 40 to 50-year-old fleet with state-of-the-art American-made equipment. I like that. The taxpayer-subsidized railroad company says its new models will have more comfortable seating and amenities like onboard Wi-Fi, individual power outlets and USB ports, as well as touchless restroom controls. All right, here is the story from the Bizarro file this morning. So, John McAfee, kind of a strange dude, let's be honest. He's a cybersecurity guy, though. He was found hanged in his jail cell and apparently had been hiding out for years in what they're calling a Spanish ghost hotel that was owned by a Russian who allegedly used this ghost hotel to run a secret Bitcoin farm. I told you I can't make this up. So John McAfee repeatedly sent out messages that he was in numerous places across the globe. Belarus, Norway, right? But people on the web started analyzing his messages and images and traced him to this hotel in Catalonia, Spain. And it was numerous tips from images of beaches, and there were different Spanish products in some of the photos that tied him to this particular Dorada Park Hotel, which they refer to as a ghost hotel. This is where no one answered the phone. You can't make reservations. And this hotel came under suspicion, I guess, from local officials after there was a huge laser pointing at the sky was built on the roof right after it was bought by this Russian businessman. Don't ask. I don't know. Why did he have a huge... I don't know. However, so apparently, officers reportedly found a set of computers in the basement and garages of this place that were constantly mining the internet to solve computer problems in exchange for a fee in Bitcoin, right? So that's how they said it was a Bitcoin farm, it was a ghost hotel, and John McAfee was in Spain living in some ghost hotel owned by a Russian. Microsoft is urging you to really update your PC immediately. It says that it wants its Windows users to immediately install an update after security researchers found a series of vulnerabilities in operations, and they say update your computer immediately. And the Regent Seven Seas has a 132-night world cruise that it thinks you're going to pay $73,000 to go on. Oh, I'm sorry. That's just if you want, like, the crappy room like I normally get, right? If you want a deluxe veranda suite, it's $199,999. It's $200,000. It is going, it's a 132-night cruise. It's going to go 34,000 plus nautical miles, stop at 66 ports. I mean, it sounds amazing. Don't get me wrong. But do I want to spend 4 months of my life on a cruise in 2024? Just between you, me, and the fence post, I really hope that I have something better to do than that in 2024. It would be nice to have $200,000 to have a veranda room by 2024, but, you know, if not, I'll just take a little carnival cruise for, you know, $200 for the weekend. This is KFI and KOSTHD2 Los Angeles. Let's go ahead and check your drive. And Jeff Baugh, good morning to you.
Good morning. Hi, Jen. Everybody. You know, Jennifer, your McAfee story, it sounds like something the wannabe screenplay writer smoking pot on a rainy day would write.
Yes, like Quentin Tarantino just sat down and was like, all right, I got this idea.
Quite bizarre. All right, good morning, all. Let's, well, first I want to warn you about, you know, since the COVID outbreak, really, Caltrans workers really kind of took advantage of the low traffic situations. Bottom line here, there's a lot of work zones still wrapping up this morning, so be careful. To start out at Riverside, though, westbound 91 around Adams, right around Adams Motorsports Park, by the way, that off-ramp was shut down due to an earlier fire, so just be careful. Going through Chino, west 91 before the 71, a problem over to the shoulder, but it's already that slow drive coming in from the 15 towards the 241. I just came out of the San Fernando Valley. As a matter of fact, we just flew over the KFI compound. I like that word, compound. Sounds pretty good. But a pretty good drive. There was a problem that I noticed going westbound, 101, right around the Sepulveda ramp before you get to the 405. It was a corner of the center divider, so they might run a break to clear that. So just be careful. But the drive was pretty good, and so was the South 405. I think we're up to a fairly good start. Nothing to report in Orange County. Yeah, it looks pretty good. We're up to a good start. Don't go away. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, superlawyer.com. KFI in the sky gets you there much faster. I'm Jeff Fogg.
Get sizzling solar savings now with Semper Solaris, your local veteran-owned solar and battery storage contractor. Being veteran-owned matters. Here's veteran, founder, and owner Kelly Shawhan.
In the military, when you give your word, it just is your word. Work hard and keep your word, and that's what we do every single day. Everybody did exactly what they said they were going to do, and that really impressed me. I heard about Semper Solaris and found out that they were veterans, so I knew they were going to do the job right.
Declare your energy independence. Choose solar panels made in America. We get the job done right with esprit de corps and honor. Add Tesla Powerwall and prepare for blackouts. Grab the federal 26% solar and battery tax credit. No interest or payments until 2022. Call 415-354-2969. 415-354-2969. Or visit SemperSolaris.com.
26% federal tax credit based on eligibility. Consult your tax advisor. Cannot be combined with any other offers. On approved credit. New customers only. Some restrictions apply. Expires 8/31/21. CSLV number 978152.
Look, staying healthy isn't easy. Watching your diet, hitting the gym, avoiding stress. But a good night's rest helps boost your overall health and wellness. And it couldn't be easier. The new Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed is the only bed that effortlessly adjusts in response to both of you. The result? You wake up ready for anything. Proven quality sleep is life-changing sleep. During our lowest prices of the season, the new Queen Sleep Number 360 C2 Smart Bed is only $899. Only for a limited time. To learn more, go to sleepnumber.com.
SoCal weather from KFI. Looks like it's going to be a nice day ahead if you like it hot. Temperatures are going to be in the 60s and mid-70s at the coast. We'll be in the mid-80s for Metro LA and OC. We've got a heat advisory with temps in the upper 90s to the low 100s for the valleys in the IE. And today highs there will be around 108. We're expecting 115 by the weekend. We lead local. Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee. This has been your wake-up call. Handle on the News with Wayne starts now.
Handle on the News.
Jennifer Jones Lee is here. Good morning.
Hi, Wayne.
Hi.
Hey, I want to tell you, I'm following up on some breaking news that we just got. Police in Redlands say they're investigating a report of a fire engine being shot at. They see at least one shot was reported at the Redlands Fire Department. Somebody shot at the engine last night. The bullet went through the windshield on the driver's side, but the firefighters who were in the rig at the time were not hurt.
It was at the station?
It was on Lassen and...
Oh, it was out in the community.
I think they were out in the community,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, no, no, no. Well...
So they're doing their job. I don't know if they were answering a call or what, but somebody freaking shoots at firefighters? What is going on?
Well, it's happened before, and I think it may be part of something we're going to be talking about pretty soon here in Handle on the News, which is a spike in homicides and shootings, and LAPD saying there are guns everywhere now. And this probably goes right along with that. And a lot of criminal justice experts, sociologists, are saying this is going to be a particularly nasty, violent summer all around the country, not just here in L.A.
Right.
And so when you tell me that, I say that goes with what apparently is the trend. There's just people out there now. You always have a certain, look, you always have the situations between people who know each other.
Yeah.
Now, you're always going to have that and then bang, bang, bang. And you're always going to have the gang, turf war, retaliation stuff. You're always going to have that. You're always going to have a certain amount of violent crime, robberies and things like that. There appears to be a massive increase in a pandemic-related phenomenon.
Yes, I agree.
And, you know, and this might be that. I mean, who knows for sure what the motivation is to shoot at a fire truck, but it is part of a bigger problem, and I'll be real honest with you. Everything I'm reading has me, I'm a little scared. Because you know what it is? It's a matter of how bad is it going to get. Right?
Yeah.
I mean, crime was down. Homicides are up. How much more up? Are we going to see a level of violence that we have never seen before? And then what happens? Right? Cops can't. I don't know how much more of an increase in crime cops can handle. They don't have the resources to handle a massive spike. All right, you know what? I should shut up about all the gloom and doom. Some of the specifics about what I'm talking about will be coming up in a couple of minutes. Tyler, good morning. Running the board.
Good morning, sir.
And John Ramirez is here editing a fairly compressed waveform. I'm looking at his computer screen. And
good morning.
Hi, I'm not seeing a ton of dynamic range on that waveform. What is that you're editing?
Oh, no.
Now I do see some more peaks. What are you editing?
I'm editing Jen's podcast, actually.
Oh, there you go. Makes sense. Radio audio is smash. It is compressed into oblivion for broadcast. That's just what happens. And Alec.
Hi.
Let's start handle on the news right now. It's Jennifer Jones Lee and me. Lead story is they're done with search and rescue. It is now only a recovery effort at the condo tower in Florida that collapsed. And guess, would you want to be the person who has to go to the family members and they're crying right in front of you? They're crying and you have to tell them there's no chance that their loved one is alive in there. Well, that's what the emergency workers had to do. Because it collapses a pancake. So it's a floor on top of a floor, on top of a floor, on top of a floor. And the amount of time that you would have to survive is so minimal in a situation like that. And they think it's going to be weeks, this recovery effort. And it's going to be nothing but grim, right? You can cross your fingers and hope and pray that there'll be some happy event that, like, they found somebody still alive. But I wouldn't count on that happening.
Honestly, I would think that the only way that they would, in quotes, find somebody alive, if there is somebody who is out of the country in some random remote spot where they don't have internet service, who lived in that condo complex and is one of the unaccounted for.
That's true. That could happen.
I guess. I mean, but even that is, I mean, a thread of a hope at best.
They'd have to be very isolated to not by now have heard what happened and reach out to somebody.
All right. Well, we have hit the 4 million mark when it comes to deaths from COVID-19 globally. And I didn't not think that this number wouldn't come, but I thought it was interesting that it just took 82 days to hit the last million mark.
You need to go from 3 to 4?
3 to 4 million, yeah. 82 days. India has had the biggest increase in COVID-19 deaths at 26%, followed by Brazil, but the U.S. still accounts for in the top three of the most deaths around the world.
Although we had most of ours in the first.
Right. At the beginning, and now you're seeing the India and Brazil's coming here at the end.
Sure. Lower vaccination rates. And then it's these variants. It's these mutations now that are driving it. So this is another situation that's probably going to get worse again before it gets any better. Let's get some news from Jennifer Jonesley, and then we'll continue handle on the news right here on KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Well, 40 to 50 times a year now, new teams from the California Department of Justice will be expected to go to fatal police shootings. Those investigations have previously been handled by local agencies, with local DAs making a decision on whether the shootings were legally justified. Iraqi security forces say rockets have landed in and around the fortified green zone in Baghdad, where the U.S. Embassy is located. There are reports of damage, and there are new developments in the assassination of Haiti's president. Four suspects now have been killed. Two others have been arrested. The president's wife was also shot. She's recovering in a hospital in Florida. Officials have declared a state of siege, as they're calling it, in the country, and they have closed an airport. We'll take a look at your drive with VKFI in the sky next.
Neil Savager here. About 3 years ago, my wife and I called American Vision Windows. They installed gorgeous French doors for us, changed the flow of our home, added architectural appeal. The next project they're doing, our kitchen windows. We can't wait. Their work is meticulous. It's outstanding. I recommended them to my brother, Craig, and now he and his family have a lovely window and case patio, added 150 sunny square feet to their home. We all know Bill and Kathleen's story. They had a horrible experience replacing their own windows. They started their own company. Fast forward 20 years. Years later, they continue to beautify homes like mine with personal care, complete professionalism, and attention. CSLB number 778-326. Give you and your home the gift of light, warmth, and beauty. Trust the window company my family trusts, American Vision Windows. You'll see the difference. Call American Vision Windows today for that free estimate, 888-226-9908. That's 888-226-9908. Or for specials, visit AmericanVisionWindows.com.
Amtrak. Whether you're craving a breath of fresh mountain air, an exciting new adventure, or just some free babysitting from Grandma, Amtrak can get you there. With more than 500 destinations across the country, everything you're missing, just an Amtrak away.
SoCal weather from KFI, partly cloudy with highs from the upper 60s at the beaches to the low 100s inland. This report is brought to you by Amtrak. Let's take a look at your drive. Where are you heading, Jeff?
We're heading to Carson. Just want to give you a heads up. I was just getting word of this from CHP. Northbound 110, the Harbor Freeway, right at the 405. It's an extremely busy spot, but word of a crash there. And even more problems as you continue north past that, going into downtown. A little bit of a fire at Vernon. That's about the halfway mark before you get to downtown Los Angeles. UC Riverside, if that's where you are right now. Southbound 215 around MLK Boulevard, Martin Luther King Boulevard. A couple of trucks got together there, so fire department is responding. Be careful. We're headed out to Diamond Bar for a problem South 57 around Diamond Bar Boulevard. More on that in a moment. But as I speak to you right now, we're flying east over the 60, coming up over Azusa. And it's a pretty good drive right through the 605. By the way, so was the 210 through Santa Anita. 605 in towards Pasadena. It was all looking pretty good. Injured in an accident, visit superwomansuperlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the sky.
This report is sponsored by the Auto Club of Southern California. Looking to save money on auto insurance? It's easy. Get your free quote at AAA.com/insurance. You could save even more when you bundle your homeowner's or renter's policy, too. Visit AAA.com/insurance today for your free quote.
Hey, Gary, how are things?
Things are great, but I crushed my mortgage payment with owning without even leaving my couch. I got a no closing cost refi at a great low rate, and owning did it all in less than 3 weeks. It was easy. No muss, no fuss.
Be like Gary. Call Owning at 855-5-OWNING and crush your mortgage payment with today's 30-year fixed refi at 2.75% rated APR with no closing costs. None. Zero. Even if you've refinanced recently, call 855-5-OWNING and let us crush your monthly payment even more. That's 855-5-OWNING or log on to owning.com.
NMLS 2611, licensed by the Department of Financial Protection and Innovation under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act. Subject to credit approval. Call 833-852-6464 for terms and conditions.
You can crush it too with a 30-year fixed 2.75% rate and APR with absolutely no closing costs.
Attention savvy investors. Are you looking to hedge against inflation and receive steady monthly cash flow? How about the safety and security of a real estate investment without the hassles of being a landlord? Maybe you should cash out of some stock market risk and volatility and take some money off the table. Instead, receive 10% annualized monthly payouts with bonuses targeted to 21%. NRIA is an industry-leading real estate development firm in its 15th year constructing strategically located, lower-risk, high-demand properties in unique neighborhoods based on supply-demand imbalance. Call 800-800-1414 to start your due diligence. A great fit for safety-oriented investors desiring monthly cash flow and diversification into carefully curated real estate. Learn more about the NRIA Real Estate Development Fund at NRIA.net or call 800-800-1414. That's 800-800-1414.
An offer of securities is only made by the NRIA Private Placement Memorandum. Read it first. Past performance does not guarantee future results. NRIA is a real estate development firm. Learn more at NRIA.net.
It's getting hot out there.
SolarMax wants to work with you to create a system that fits your budget.
A package that includes a solar system and home battery backup for $69.98 a month and APR as low as 0.99%.
Offers good till July 31st. Go to SolarMaxTech.com. Monthly payment available on approved credit. CSLB number 97204.
Anthem, Blue Cross, and Heart of America are helping schools across the country increase their access to healthy food. Learn more at anthem.com/ca/sparks. Anthem Blue Cross is the trade name of Blue Cross of California.
You don't want to mess with the IRS. They have the power to garnish your paycheck, levy your bank accounts, and even take your home or business. That's all true. But thankfully, they're offering a way out. The Fresh Start Initiative. If you qualify, you can save thousands. The experts at Optima Tax Relief will fight to get you the best deal possible. And they have an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau to prove it. Call Optima for your free consultation.
Call 800-783-8055. 800-783-8055.
Optima Tax Relief.
For details, visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
Don't wait for the furniture of your dreams. Get it today during Court Furniture Outlet's annual Independence Day sale, where all furniture is in stock and ready for immediate delivery. Court furniture prices are always super low because they lease their furniture for use in model homes, movies, and television by home stagers and corporate offices. And when the furniture comes back, they sell it for pennies on the dollar. Now save even more on an incredible selection of new and used home and office furniture. New upholstery sets in several styles and colors, including leather sectionals, special buys on mattress sets, and commercial office chairs from just $49. Plus great deals on so much more, and all in stock. Come and see why Court has been the secret destination for families, designers, and business professionals for over 40 years. And let Court's friendly furniture consultants help you find everything you need to live and work in comfort and style. Visit our locations in Glendale on Central, in Corona at the 91 and McKinley, and now Fountain Valley at Euclid and the 405, or go to cortfurnitureoutlet.com.
57% of Republicans say the pandemic's over and only 4% of Democrats. Are people in reality distortion bubbles?
Yeah, separate universes.
How could there possibly be a political viewpoint on whether you think the pandemic is over?
Aren't they following the science? What's so hard about
that?
What
if a variant breaks through?
John and Ken.
What if an air conditioner falls on my head?
Weekdays at 2 on KFI.
At the state capitol, they had a little coronavirus outbreak. At least 9 people tested positive last week. They're saying probably it's on the assembly side of things.
Those assembly members.
Well, you know, the lower house. that's not nice. So, because they had lifted the mandate, if you were fully vaccinated and you were in your offices, you didn't have to wear a mask. In the public places in the Capitol, people were wearing masks. If you were not vaccinated, you have to be tested twice a week. So anyway, there's a breakout. And now back to masks for everybody in the offices. I was wondering, given the variants and given that the numbers are going up, I was waiting for where in society were we first going to see the re-implementation of a mask mandate. And now we have it. It's at the Capitol in Sacramento. And I'll tell you what, folks, get ready. Get ready for mask mandates to come back. I think it's only a matter of time, not a matter of if.
I think you're right, and I then wonder what's going to happen, because you're going to have a lot of people who flip the bird to wearing a mask again. They're going to, you know, I mean, in other words, horses out of the barn, and they're going to say, screw you, I'm not going back in there.
I don't know, you can't really do anything about it.
No?
But it's not going to be enforced in any meaningful way.
No, how can they?
No, you can't.
And we, I mean,
it's too bad we're that broken. We're that broken as a society that something. I'm certainly not saying you should love wearing a mask. And, you know, I'm not saying that.
No.
I got no problem with you if you think it's physically uncomfortable or whatever. I got no problem with you if you think it's, you know, government oppression. I'm not interested in having an argument that you feel that way. That's fine. But at the end of the day, it's a pretty tiny thing that you can do that is effective in slowing the spread. So, you know, is there never any point anymore where you, like, suck up your beliefs a little bit and you just do a thing that you think is wrong just to kind of pitch in? Or we're past that, right? This current crop of people that we have,
yeah,
man, oh man, if this were what we had during World War II,
oh, yeah.
We would be speaking German right now.
Right, right. Where's the pitch in that you saw there?
Are you kidding me?
Oh, my gosh.
People forget history very quickly. Anyway, mask back at them.
All right. This is a sort of do they have a case, and I want to talk to you about this one. So you have a federal judge who has found the Air Force 60% responsible for that church massacre in Texas in 2017. That's when that guy, Devin Kelly, went in. He killed, I think, 26 people, including a pregnant woman. He injured a whole bunch of others. Now, the judge said no other individual, not even Kelly's own parents or partners, knew as much about the U.S., about the violence that he had threatened to commit and was capable of committing. He served in the Air Force. He was let go because of bad conduct. He assaulted a wife and a stepson, cracked the child's skull. And apparently the Air Force failed to submit that information into an FBI database, which meant he could have been then prevented from getting a gun, buying a gun legally.
Boom. That's exactly what happened. He was court-martialed.
Yeah.
And so it should have been on his rap sheet. And they didn't submit it. So he got that gun and this judge. And so now, of course, the government's being sued. And the judge said, yeah.
My question to you is, does this case then open the door for any other case that involves any other service member who did something bad with a gun, either while they were part of the service or if they've been discharged for some reason? Does this then open the door for their victims to go after these other military agencies?
If they failed in their responsibility to report court martials to the FBI database, yeah, absolutely. It's a precedent now that can be cited. I mean, this will go up on appeal.
Oh, sure.
You know, I mean, this may end up not being the case that the Air Force is responsible once it goes through the cycle. But, yeah, this becomes a precedent. And then it'd go, well, it's already been found that when a military agency fails to report something they're supposed to report, they can be held liable. And he's got a point because, you know, nobody else was in a position to put that court-martial into the database.
Right, right.
So, and he would have not been allowed to buy that gun if it had been in there. Would he have gotten a gun some other way? Maybe. But that's all speculation, right? This case is about what happened, and they blew it. And they know they blew it, and I know that they apologize, and they're revamping their thing to make sure it doesn't happen again. And this doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, they're going to be held liable and have to pay anything. This is just the judge looking at and saying, yes, it meets a threshold to continue the case.
I just hope it's symbolic enough that other agencies go, ooh, we better shape up.
Yes.
We better double, triple check our reporting to make sure
this
doesn't fall through the cracks.
If you're going to make a mistake, let the mistake be you're reporting it twice.
Yeah, amen. Yes.
That's all. And then it's a duplicate, yes, and it gets stripped out, right?
Yep.
All right, let's get some more news from Jennifer Jones Lee, and then we will continue Handle on the News right here. It's KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the free iHeartRadio app. Jen, take it away.
L.A. County Sheriff Vina Nueva says a 10-day operation in the Antelope Valley resulted in the destruction of 17 tons of marijuana at 205 illegal pot farms. The sheriff says the farms are connected to Mexican, Armenian, and Asian crime groups.
In July of 2020, we had two murder victims who were discovered adjacent to an illegal marijuana grow in an unincorporated area of Lancaster. In March of 2021, a murder victim was found buried in a desert near Lake Los Angeles.
The sheriff says the marijuana had a street value of $1.2 billion. He says during the operation in June, more than 400 deputies served 205 search warrants and made 131 arrests. A geologist with the California Water Board says illegal pot farms expose people to harmful chemicals.
Unregulated cannabis cultivation operations often allow fertilizers, pesticides, petroleum fuels, sediment, irrigation tailwater, trash, and human waste to be released into the environment and to pollute waters of the state.
Eric Lindberg says the illegal theft of water drains lakes and streams and negatively impacts the water table. He says his agency regulates the permitting process for legal cannabis grow operations. Traffic in Orange County could get a little lighter in the near future.
The OC streetcar is expected to become a reality in 2023. The project, which is expected to cost more than $420 million, will span a bit more than 4 miles. The rail will link the Santa Ana Regional Transportation Center to streets near Little Saigon. The track is much shorter than previously proposed light rail projects and is being built in a dense working-class area away from the upscale neighborhoods in OC. Deborah Mark, KFI News.
The European Union has fined four major German carmakers $1 billion for colluding to limit the development and rollout of emission control systems. The EU says Daimler, BMW, Audi, and Porsche avoided competing on technology to restrict pollution from gas and diesel passenger cars. And one of the most famous paintings in America is leaving its home for the first time in a century. Blue Boy by Thomas Gainsborough is the star attraction at the Huntington Library in San Marino. The painting was done about 1770. A team of experts that evaluated the painting's condition in 2018 is opposed to sending the Blue Boy to London for months to be shown at Britain's National Gallery. That was the last place the painting was exhibited before it was shipped to SoCal. We're taking a look at your drive on the 110.
We're going to go through Carson now, northbound 110 to 405, if you were with us last time around. Unfortunately, so the driver lost control there and wound up in the ice plant, which is off the freeway, so sure there's a lot of activity there. And sure enough, we went out to Diamond Bar to check that South 57 around Diamond Bar Boulevard. It's always a busy spot here, the merge with the West 60 and the South 57, all that's kind of slow, but there is a rig that's over to the shoulder. I just took a look at it, not too bad. We're over the 10 now, coming well through the Covinas. It's off to a rather slow start. I must say, the volume goes up here every day, it seems. And right now, well, just a little bit west of Azusa, it's getting real slow going over towards the 605. And by the way, coming out of the high desert now, South 15, it's in fairly good shape, a little slow at the 138 merge, but pretty good driving to San Bernardino. I think you'll be okay. Even the 15 going down towards Corona, the good. The westbound 91, that's still real slow now, coming up towards the 71 and over towards the 241. So just kind of morning drive slow. Be careful. Injured in an accident, visit superwomansuperlawyer.com. Jeff Bond, KFI in the sky.
Sign on the line, 8DBH Mortgage is a fair housing lender. NMLS, 162-6699.
Some wild things happened in home lending while we were filling in for Handle. The government came out with a new program for homeowners that may have missed out on the lowest rates in lending history.
The government enacted a program just days ago giving homeowners relief on refinancing their homes this very minute.
It's called Refi Now, and millions of homeowners are eligible. You can call True Mortgage, 866-33-FASTER, or go to TrueNow.com right now. See if you qualify for this government program.
Here's the thing, it literally takes less than 5 minutes to see if you qualify. This program has one of the biggest government breaks regarding mortgage qualification guidelines ever.
It's true, credit requirements have been loosened by the federal government and rates have been reduced even lower, even for those who are self-employed.
If you're a homeowner and missed out on the lowest rates or couldn't refi, this is your time, but do it today before the program runs out.
Give them a call, 833-66-FASTER, or go to TrueNow.com. 833-66-FASTER, or dial pound 250 and say True Mortgage. That's pound 250, True Mortgage.
SoCal weather from KFI. Partly cloudy today. Highs will range from the upper 60s to mid-70s at the coast. We'll be in the mid-80s for Metro LA and OC. And we've got a heat advisory with temps in the upper 90s to low 100s for the valleys in the IE. We lead local. Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
An important message from Kaiser Permanente. Thanks to new federal funding, you may be among the millions of Americans now eligible for federal financial assistance to help lower your health coverage premiums, even if you didn't qualify before. That's right. You may now qualify for federal financial assistance to help lower your health coverage premiums, even if you didn't qualify before.
Call Kaiser Permanente now at 1-800-494-6261. That's 1-800-494-6261.
Near historical low mortgage rates won't last long. If you're buying a new home, go with a lender you can count on. For competitive rates, low fees, over 300 loan products, and thousands of loan consultants to help make sure you get the home you want. Call now for your no-obligation pre-approval. 866-888-LOAN. 866-888-LOAN. Or go to LoanDepot.com. Loan Depot, where home means everything. Rates are subject to change. Equal housing opportunity lender. NMLS number 174457. Licensed in all 50 states.
It's Riverside and Huntington Beach Harley's pre-owned red tag sale this week. Hundreds of Harleys tagged with liquidation pricing. Good credit, bad credit, no credit. 100% of applications accepted. Save thousands this week only at Riverside and Huntington Beach Harley's pre-owned red tag sale. Ends this Sunday.
Ready to turn your destination daydreams into reality?
I want to breakfast!
Norwegian Cruise Line's Freedom Sale is back and better than ever. For a limited time, enjoy 30% off, free open bar, free airfare, and more. Break free this summer to the Caribbean, Europe, or other amazing destinations. With our leading health and safety program, you can cruise with the ultimate freedom. Book today at ncl.com. Call your travel advisor or 1-888-NCL-CRUISE. Offer ends soon. Norwegian Cruise Line. Sail safe. Feel free. Ships registry to Bahamas and USA. Restrictions apply.
This week, stop by your neighborhood grocery outlet. Get an amazing deal on Naked Brand Strawberry Banana Smoothie. 64-ounce bottles are just $2.99, a savings of up to 65%.
Termite problems? Search PacificCoastTermite.com or call 800-PACIFIC.
For official rules and more information about contests on this station,
go to KFIAM640.com/rules.
Live.
KFI AM
640. Local. And iHeart Radio Station. KFI AM 640. Live everywhere on the iHeart Radio app. So Bill Handel's show, he's out today. We're doing Handel on the News. Jennifer Jones-Lee and me. Oh, and this is the thing we started talking about at the top of the show. 12 people dead across L.A. after the 4th of July weekend. Homicides are up 25% so far this year across L.A. But if you go to certain areas like South Los Angeles, there homicides are up 50% year over year. Shootings across the city are up by about the same. And the police, community activists, criminologists, sociologists are all saying here and in other big cities across the country, it's going to be a very violent summer. They're blaming the pandemic. And they're specifically pointing to something I didn't think about until they pointed it out. One of the effects of the pandemic is that most of the social service structures that mediate violence in the community were taken out of commission, particularly gang intervention, and particularly the direct intervention against retaliation that happens where, let's say, there's a shooting and